Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Scrap Mechanics. I'm AC Gamer.
This is Cypher Deck.
And we are going to be joining you here in our little build. Did we come up with a name for this? Is it the ladybug?
I think it's the ladybug or the cricket.
Or the cricket, yeah, it could be the cricket. Although we need some really big wings. Oh my god. Oh, jeez. We're getting some pretty decent air up there, actually.
Yeah.
That is nuts.
Okay, it looks like we can actually probably make this back heavy a little bit more. Or is it front heavy?
You know, it tips up in the front, because I think there's too much thrust in the back. So you could make the front a little heavier.
We could lower the thrust in the back to
Then it wouldn't look as cool. It wouldn't look as cool. Look at that. Looks wicked.
It would look as cool. I mean, the thrusters aren't moving.
All you gotta do is add some weight up here. You just need to throw some like heavy bedding up there. Oh, you know what you need? Because you're doing such fast blast off. You need to get some glass in here, like right there. Did I get it in there right? No, that's a little bit off.
Nope.
Let me see if I can get that on there right. Or if you can get it.
I'll try it. Let me see. Let me get that off there. Glass.
Nope. That's still off. Yeah, you want the big piece. Because you got to have something, man. You don't have any sunglasses. Your eyes are going to get dried out.
It's going to be off either way.
Oh, there we go. Right there.
Yeah, it's kind of off. We kind of need a vehicle that's 4 wide. We can actually do that, but if you want, we can remake this as a 4 wide vehicle.
Well, we got to do Santa's little sled, man.
Well, that I want to actually do like a sled, like an actual sled.
Yeah, we can do that.
All right, let me.
You want to make it out of wood?
Well, we definitely need to make it out of wood. Yeah. So if you want, we need to put that down and make a big base, like not too wide, but long.
How many wide? Even? 4? 6?
I'd say, well, we want to, we need it to be at least 8. 8 wide.
8 wide?
Yeah.
So 2 more. There you go. That is 8 wide right there.
Okay, and then go ahead and put the, that's mine, isn't it? Let's go ahead and put that down. Go ahead and put it back on a lift so it's centered.
Oh, yeah, let me see if I can find my lift. There you go.
Okay, and yeah, we want it to be, I mean, we need to have, here's what I'm thinking. Get these. Want 2 of these side by side. So it needs to be 1 more wide. Actually, 2 more wide. 2 wide on this side and 1 more wide on the other side so that we can actually have the sleigh going upward. And then we're going to cut it off and start rounding it upward so that it looks like the front of the sleigh.
Well, I mean, 2 more wide on this side and 1 more on the other side, that's not going to be even, is it?
Yeah. Yeah, it will. Will it not?
I don't know, because I was doing 2 at a time, so I just figured this was going to be off by 1. What do we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
yeah,
8,
if you look
9,
at the,
okay,
the chairs themselves.
There's 10. There's 10 of them.
Yeah. And then that way we can actually put a wall. Or we want to go ahead and raise that now.
Raise what?
And we can raise that.
The actual chair?
Mm-hmm. And keep raising. And then we want to go ahead and start putting our sleigh, like the actual sleigh portions.
See, that's going to be tricky because you're going to want round pieces on the front piece.
Well, yeah, we're going to use piping for it. But, and then say back here. It's two down right there. Two or three? Is that three? Yeah. And then we'll use this new piping that they actually added.
Yeah, I guess we could use that. And then we'll color it up.
We'll use this. Wow, this pipe is so small. It's much smaller than I thought it was.
Maybe the big red one?
Well, no, that'd be too big.
It's really not that big.
The older stuff. There's this stuff. Let's try this one. Yeah. You don't think that's big?
Yeah, it's a little bit big.
Here, let's try this one.
Yeah, that's about the right size, actually.
And then you have these pieces that come out this way.
Let me see. What color would it be? Silver, right?
Oh, we need to move these up one more. Actually, do we want to have the whole thing be metal going up to the...
Well, I mean,
if it's silver or black.
If it's the bottom part, then yeah.
The color.
You what?
Yeah, let's go ahead and have the... Oh, sorry. We'll reattach it here in a second.
Oh, you want the actual brackets coming down to be made out of that as
yeah.
well? Okay.
Let's see, right here. And then weld gun.
Oh, you actually welded? Yeah, you're welding it back on. Nice.
Yep.
Okay, so which way is going to be the front? Oh, up here. Up here is the front.
Up there is going to be the front, and then that means we need to have this tail come back one more like that, and then that way it's. Yeah, and then the front is going to curve up.
Wait, I think you have the back curve up as well, but it doesn't curve up as much as the front. So, like, this would only be, like, a one piece.
Okay.
And then this one up here would be, like, a two curved, or maybe even a three curved. And this one back here could be, like, a two, maybe.
Yeah, let me get the curve first. Like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
That actually looks pretty good.
And then have this.
Yeah, this next one might be kind of hard to simulate the actual curvature.
What do you mean?
Well, because you don't want it to be exactly like this. Like, this is way too short for the front piece. But you, like, I don't understand how you're going to make it go at an angle more of sliding straight up. Unless
lower it down just a little bit so that the bar is eye level to our characters. Yeah, like that.
What if you used, where are the little tiny ramps? The these pieces right here.
Like that?
I guess.
I mean, we can even go back like that.
What if you use something like that? No, I guess that wouldn't do it, right?
Mm-mm. We're going to use that to actually make the front slope up on the sleigh.
Yeah, that's not too bad right there. Actually, I think that little curved piece that you threw on there was a good little addition. So now we just need to do the same thing on the other side.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, guys. We're going to have... what are we going to do for reindeer, though? You think we can make reindeer?
Oh, we're going to have rockets. Rocket reindeer.
Well, I mean, we're going to have rockets, but you got to have reindeer out front. Even if they don't do anything.
I don't know how we would do reindeer.
We'd have to sit there and, like, actually make them from scratch.
Well, they'd have to be balanced. What we could do is we could just have them on, like... rockets are the actual reindeer, and then they're tethered along on something that it has no that's flexible. So the rotors that aren't connected to a box or anything like that. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It's the only way I could think of doing that.
Well, it's probably getting ahead of ourselves first, because we just need to make the actual
sleigh.
Yeah. Because we still have the whole top piece, guys. I mean, we got to put the chair in there. We got to have, like, the red velvet that they always have in there. And then at one point, we need, like, another three or four of us to stand on top of each other's shoulders and actually make the real Santa. So somebody can write this. Because we're actually the little elves. We're the elves that help make Santa's workshop right here. This is very, very small guys. Listen to that music come in there. It just kind of kicked in. It's like, oh, yeah. You're going to have fun. You're going to build something. And that comes all the way up to the very end, doesn't it?
Yep.
This front piece kind of... We might have to shorten that up a little bit. Oh,
yeah. That's what I'm thinking. I'm going to shorten it real quick.
Oh, that might be way too short.
No, because we're going to slope up going in. So it'll end up coming up to about the same... same front as that sled is.
Oh, so you're gonna leave that piece of wood there?
No, I'm getting rid of this piece of wood. I'll show you what I'm thinking. Right. Yeah, perfect. So if you want to put down a layer of those angled pieces.
Facing which way, up or down?
Up.
Like that?
Yep.
Alright. Only thing is, we're going to have to color these. I'm not sure what color we're going to use.
Oh. And then go ahead and put another one.
There we go. And you want another one?
Yep. And then let me know when it's even.
What do you mean even?
Even with the bars down there. Like that would be perfect right there.
So one more layer now?
No, that's perfect. Now go ahead and fill in these so that they're angled on inside the...
Oh, okay, I see what you're doing.
Yeah, and then we're going to come back one. I think, or maybe just have it like that. The sleigh is what color is red, right?
Well, the inside is usually that crushed velvet that he got on the seats and stuff, but the outside was always wood. So I kind of wanted to keep the look of the wood, but
okay. We have these, well, we can do that.
These orange ones on there, we need a certain color for that.
So instead of doing this last like in here, go ahead and do that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and have this come up to about there.
Now, what colors for you have always kind of screamed Christmas? Is there one color in particular? Do you like the blues, the greens, you know?
Oh, the reds and greens. Okay, so this whole layer that's around this red here that you've just done,
uh-huh.
This is the inside. I'll do a second layer on the outside.
All right, since that is going to be the inside, I'll go ahead and pick a dark green for out here.
Okay, and then we're going to need to do one more of these angle pieces out from these sides.
From which sides?
From
both sides?
From the sides. From both sides, yeah.
On the very bottom or every row?
That's going to be the... No, on each corner here. Like here, here, and here. Like that.
Okay.
because I want to go ahead. That will make it so that this whole section will be on the outside.
There you go. Let me go ahead and color those. Oh, okay, so the inside is going to be like a dual layer of wood. Yep.
Then you could paint the outside one color, the inside another color.
Yeah. That's not too bad. That's a good idea. So green and what? Blue maybe? Well, I mean, you want the wood to be completely wood on the outside, I think. On the inside, though, we can go with different colors. Although it's kind of crowded in here. Yeah, like all you got room for is his seat. You actually only need one seat in here. The back one could be like a little back bench that we could set up for the presents. Because he always has two layers, you know. He has his seat up in the front, and then the seat.
Well, these are just placers just to make sure it was wide enough.
Right.
Because we're going to put, let's see. Oh, still weird things. All right, watch out. Move forward.
What is that?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
That's his seat?
Oh, no. This whole...
What are you making?
This is to lift him up high enough so that he can see over the front of it.
Okay. I still think we need to make it a little bit wider.
Really? I mean, it's up to you.
Yeah, just maybe one more layer on both sides.
And then cut out the inside here?
Yeah, just to give it a little bit more room, because it does feel kind of claustrophobic in here. You're talking about a big guy with a lot of presence, so... Let's go ahead and put up a back seat right there. And you know what? We could actually, since we're going to color these anyways, maybe we'll just put in a row so that we can have a seat that slopes a little bit. Maybe one more? Let's get rid of this row. Come on, get rid of it. Nope, it did not get rid of it for me, dang it.
Get rid of what?
I'm just trying to get rid of that wood right there. I'm trying to
create... Well, we need to have enough room for the bag.
Well, the bag usually goes in the back seat, doesn't it?
Yeah. Oh, is that this area here?
Mm-hmm.
Then we need to go one more wide all the way across.
There we go. Let's do this again. I have another idea back here. That's one heck of a backseat, guys. We'll go up one more. There we go. And I think I'll leave that little gap in there. I mean, I'll let you look at it and tell me what you think, if we should have it as well. But I'm thinking leaving that little gap in there will kind of make it more of a seat. I know this needs to be red. You think it should have the thing all the way on the back?
What do you mean? Oh, which gap? You mean this gap right here?
Yeah.
I think that's fine.
Because then we can change the color a little bit. Put some blue in there, maybe. Like that. I don't know. I don't know if that really... Like maybe not that blue. Or maybe just all red. No, that doesn't fit either. How about green? Yeah, I'm not sold on it. I could take it or leave it.
Yeah.
A little bit too much green, maybe. I don't know. We'll have to play around with that a little bit. Figure it out. With the other colors that are going to be on the map with it, that's going to make a big impact.
Yep.
Let me go ahead and...
Let's see here.
Okay, so that's in there. What color do you think his seat should be?
Probably white or black, right?
You know, I mean, black seems a little dark for him, doesn't it?
I thought he had a black seat, or, I don't know. I mean, he's going to have to have a seat that's a controlled seat, like this one.
Oh, that's true. But I mean, aren't there different types of seats? Like the toilet? Well, I mean, you did not necessarily, you know, the toilet in mind, but there's like smaller ones, right? That you can use, or does it have to have a steering wheel?
I mean, it has to have a steering wheel to be able to control it.
Oh, okay. So these little seats that you can throw on the back. Like that. Could be a little bit better. In fact, if we cut little placements for them, oh, that's gonna be cool. Okay, let me do this real quick. Let me cut some placements for them. I think that's what we were missing. Is I was trying to put them in here, without realizing they still need to fit. So let's go ahead. Nope, that is not right. Let's see. How big are these, by the way? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we need to kick a few more away. So what are you doing over there on your end?
I'm just finishing up the outside. I have two layers now that are wider. I mean, it's made the whole area wider than it was before. And I'm trying to get it to do what I want it to. There we go.
How's that look?
I
like
it. I mean, you probably need to pull it up and then paint under it and then put it down.
Well, I mean, I can paint underneath it pretty easy.
Well,
like that.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm just not sure if it needs this extra layer right here.
Maybe like make this, it red.
What, the seat?
Maybe make the seat red, and it kind of mixes with the red on the armrests.
Like that?
Yeah. Ah, I didn't mean to do that.
Ah, that's right. I got it right on here. There we go. Let me see. Can I throw in some blocks behind?
And then put it like this right here is green over here.
Oh, okay.
It comes through over when you're looking at the red seat.
There we go. Yeah, I don't know how we'll fit the other seat in there. Get rid of that block. There we go. Wow, that's, you know, it's not too bad. I really don't think we can fit this other one in, though. Which is kind of a shame.
Which one?
This other seat.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, to fit it in there, you can see it would have to go straight back, so we wouldn't have a board in between it. Like, we'd have to expand these walls. Two more.
I was going to.
Oh, you are?
Well, two more. I was going to do, I still have to do this side. I was going to expand this wall out from here. Why are these never in the direction I want them to be in? I was going to go out to here on this side, and then do a second layer going out. So this would be the outside layer. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you'd have a whole lot more room. Go ahead and put that down for you.
See, like right there. So we still need... let's see. Nope, that's not the right angle. Dang it. Let me look at the block. I wish when you had the paintbrush on, you could change the angle at which you were... Dang it, that's still not doing it. That's the right angle. No, it just won't let me do it. So we're just going to have to get rid of that object. And then come in here and do it. Okay, so yeah, I just didn't want to do it with the object on there, which is weird because I put down a chair before.
Actually, and painted before you, do that chair, yeah, take the chair out real quick.
You want like a stripe or something? Well, you can't do that right there because the chair doesn't fit over.
No, it will, because we're gonna move that chair. And then this one. Will be coming over here. As of the width of this new one.
Okay, I see what you're doing.
Yep. There you go.
Alright, let me go ahead and put the chairs back down. And then go ahead and repaint these things. There we go. There's a little bit of green in there I want to cover up. Or I should say a little bit of wood. And what color were we doing the chairs? That was all...
Red, and then have the corner pieces red. Like the... yeah. I think that's how you were doing it.
Yeah. There we go. All right, let me go ahead and paint these things.
Okay.
Red.
Once you do that, I'm going to then figure out where I need everything else to be so I have two layers. I think this is actually...
You think it's what?
It's perfect for what I'm doing here.
A little bit too much red, I think. I think green, maybe? Green for the centerpieces?
Is that as far down as that can go?
What's that?
Can you push... Oh, wait a minute. Never mind. I can jump over here. This ends. Ah, I fell off again.
Yeah, we need to put like a door on here.
Yeah.
All right, so that's not too bad right there. She's gonna need something else up here. It's a nice little crushed red velvet. You need some kind of computer controls in there, though. What do we got for computer controls that would look kind of fancy?
What do you mean? Oh, you could put the control boxes.
And the buttons, if it will let you.
Well, I mean, yeah, because we're going to have buttons for the doors, and then probably buttons for the, we may not need that many, but...
No, I mean, yeah, but you can move them around as you need to.
And then, what you could do for here... One more. Oh, no, that's right. You're right.
So there you go. And see, can I paint it? Oh, I can.
Do we want them up or out?
I don't know. Point it straight out? Like if it's looking straight at them from sitting down?
Alright.
Hmm.
Like that?
You know, I mean, it could go either way, actually. They both look pretty good. That's gonna be up to you on that one. What do you think?
One, two... How many did you go over on that side?
One, two... What do you mean? How many did I go over?
Oh, I'm just trying to make it as even as possible. Just do that. And I'll do an angle.
Don't forget, we got the logic gate and the...
Oh, the flux capacitors.
Yeah, like that.
We could put those, like, right next to these. So, have one on
Wait, have it go down one. And then put it in there.
Okay.
Like that. Maybe?
Well, we need to make sure that we get these lined up, because...
Yeah, fill out.
One second. Yeah, let's just take off this last one here. And then we'll do this the old-fashioned way, as they say. Yeah. And then put one on this side. Oh. You go. Now try it.
Well, I mean, do we want to do the same on both sides? Because we got the single one, and we have the double one. Like, this is a single over here. That's a double. Because I don't know if you want to go too crazy with it. I mean, you want it to look futuristic, but maybe have some space in there for, like, the red. Because we could do it up here in the front. Like, right there.
Actually, we need to move the turn it till to the D is facing forward. I don't know if we want those going on. Didn't mean to do that. Let me check the front. I messed up. Hey.
Yeah, I'm trying to picture it, and I think we need a little bit of space on the sides. One, two, three, so maybe something special there. How big were those boxes again? Were they three wide or two?
Which ones?
The control boxes.
Two wide.
Alright, let me take that down and put that back on. Nope, that is not it. Still not it. How'd you get it to go up?
What do you mean?
There we go. Alright, so... In the center, we could put something like... That looks kind of cool. What if I paint that? How does that look to you?
One second.
That way it's not too futuristic, but it does give it a little bit of pizzazz.
Oh, that's good.
I mean, we can go with more if you want. I just don't want to go too much.
I like the three in the middle.
And then
could put a...
same back here.
Probably put the logic gates in, too. I mean, where are those at? Like in the middle?
You can put like one down there?
Have the logic gate going. like that.
What if you had it stick straight up so it's even taller? So instead of putting it down one, you have it stick up. That way it looks a little different from... I don't have that one on my list.
I know. I was going to say color.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
There you go. So that's kind of unique.
Yep.
And then the switches are all up there. And then, you know, like this one right here on the top. I don't know if you want to keep that one there in between the switch or throw another few of them in there, or if you think that's already enough the way it is and just go with some actual wood. That's not going to work. I think we need green out here. Oof. There we go. Do we want green out here? I mean, this green is the only thing I can think of to go with the outside, because I think red would be a little bit too much, right? Like, we want a good combination of red and green, but...
Yeah.
It seems like red's kind of taken over a little bit. I don't think we want to make your chair green. Red. And you said black in here, right? Is what you want it?
I mean, it's up to you. What do you think?
You know, I don't know. I mean, black looks good. But it might be too dark for the area. Let's try white. Let's see what white looks like with that.
Yep. Actually, that probably should.
Oof, that's a little way too bright, actually, now I'm looking at it. What if you, instead of doing wood as the floor panel for his chair, you use that starlight brick? You know, because it is kind of magical. Or, you know what, instead of using the wood blocks up here, what if we use that starlight? That way it will kind of add to the essence. Is that it? Or is it turned sideways?
That's it. No, you got it.
Because I don't see...
Yeah, it has to be multiples.
Oh, it has to be multiples?
Yeah. Ah. Sorry. Let's see. No.
Let's go back to green on this one. I don't know about that. I don't really like the white flooring. I think black, unfortunately, looked a little bit better.
Yeah.
Still think this might be a tad bit too dark for him. Let's put this in there. Especially, like, where the stairs are. That's where you'd almost like want to do that starlight. Let's get rid of these. There we go. I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of all this up here, and we'll replace it. There we go. It takes a little while to get this right, guys, but we'll get there. Let's get this gone as well. And then we're going to put that entire row right back. Oh, there we go.
Hopefully this works the way I want it to. Let's go ahead and take it off of the ramp. Or off the lift. Because I want to... Oops. Are we on an angle? Let's see. We're going to go ahead and... get our tool out. Hopefully.
I guess that works. What are you building the door right now?
Yeah, there's something wrong with it though. So I'm gonna have to redo it.
What do you mean, what's wrong with it?
It didn't make the way I wanted it to.
Blue, maybe not so much. Let's go with dark green. Yeah, that's not too bad. Give it a little bit of...
Hit this back door real quick with a hammer.
Let me put the hammer back on real quick. The one I'm standing right next to?
Yep.
It ain't going to anywhere.
I wonder why. Oh, I think I know why.
It's not lining up either.
There we go.
There. Is that you're going to have it not, open?
No. Well, no. I actually have... I just need to make sure it would open. And... Alright. And then we're going to come in here. We're going to make it zippy. We're going to put it on this first one here. Have this on that. That go to there. And we need to then replace this floor.
Yeah, we got the blackness going away there. I think that looks a little bit better. Let's see. I think this is going to have to come out a little bit further, actually. Maybe one more? How many is it over here on this end? One, two. So one, two. That's one, two. So let's do that. And we'll put in the little step stool right there. I don't know. We'll have to see. That looks like a very, very big floor. But I think in the end, it's going to let it be a little bit more even. Actually, you know what? What if we just got rid of one of the floors up here? There we go. Make it a little shorter there. We'll make it a little shorter back here so it fits in a little bit better. How's that look? Is that a little too short up there in the front, you think?
One second. What's going on?
Up here. You know what? If we put another row of wood there, give it that nice little step. So he can get down, work his controls, do his thing.
Yeah. All right, let's go ahead and put it. Uh-oh. Click through. All right.
What's going on? Is it not working?
Oh, no. I clicked through to the desktop, apparently.
Oh, okay. Well, guys, I think this is a good spot to go ahead and end the part one of our Santa Claus build here. We're going to continue on with this on the next episode. And I think we're pretty close to being able to put boosters in here. And maybe, you think the booster should be hidden? Like extend the sled back a little bit further and then like hide them in the wood? Yeah. Or
yeah? Yeah, plus we're going to have boosters for the reindeer. And we're going to find a way to make those things turn. I don't know how, but we'll figure it out.
And as always, guys, I am AC Gamer.
And this is Cypher Deck.
And we will definitely catch you next time.
Bye.
Hey, guys, and welcome to the disembodied voice of AC Gamer. We are definitely going to be doing a lot more series in the future, but here are a few of them that you guys might find interesting. Of course, you're more than welcome to check them out. I would love to hear your comments. Again, if you do enjoy these videos, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe. It's definitely the indicator that I use to tell if you guys want to see more videos like that, of that particular game style, of that series in the long run. So when you guys leave comments down, it helps me decide whether we should keep doing it, as well as whether you want to see games like that in the future. And here are a few of them right here. I kind of picked out a few of different genres. We will be doing spotlights for other YouTubers in the future. So if you want to get a little shout out, definitely let me know. If you group with me, chances are you will get a shout out in here eventually. But for now, these are just four series that I have that I feel like could use a little bit more attention and that you guys might actually enjoy as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and we will definitely catch you all next time.